Schwartz meets Cohn in the garment district. And he says, I heard about the fire. He says, shh, tomorrow.
I had a peculiar childhood in that my mother, who sort of was like the woman in Next Stop Running is Philip, Shelley Winters played her. My mother was a lower middle class Jewish woman, was well read, loved opera, loved music, loved movies, and took her kid, her only child. I would cut school. She'd say to me, stay home today, we'll go to the movies.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of.
He was a comic. He did a stand-up comic act.
Now look here, Betsy. I know you're married to that little Jew, Mazursky, but frankly, I don't give a damn.
Oh, Betsy, this is your old friend, Peter Lorre. Let me suck the foam out of your tub.
Yeah, now look here, Betsy. I'm glad to see you smiling. But as soon as you get out of that tub, I'm gonna slap the crap out of you.
Some of the years ago, and my memory's not that good, I met this college girl in Greenwich Village. She's the best I ever had. Ripped my t-shirt into shreds, and I used it in a streetcar.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone.
And I ring the doorbell, and I go upstairs. I walked up three or four flights, and the door opens, and this guy with the dark eyes, and he said to me, I'm Stanley Kubrick. And I said, I'm Irwin Mazursky. So I read. I have no idea what I'm reading. He said, okay, you got the part. We leave Monday for California. I said, but I'm graduating from college. I can't do that. He said, you can do it. Go to the dean and tell him you're in a big Hollywood movie. And when I saw it, I figured, Oscar. A movie which, by the way, Stanley later tried to have the negative burned.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock.
One day, John Cassavetes came in, and he was a hot young actor. I knew who he was. I didn't know him. You want to go up for a part in this movie they're casting at MGM? They're looking for punks. And I nudged Harry. And Cassavetes said, yeah, I'll take you up too. So I went up, and I got the part. Me, Vic Morrow, Sidney Poitier.
Did he seem like he would ever become anything?
Did he become something?
Yeah.
You're pulling my leg.
Let's go, bright boy.
Hey, wait. He means me.
I never thought about being a director. Mm-hmm. I was only thought about playing Hamlet.
Are you going to paint her into your skin?
Death Watch, starring Leonard Nimoy and me, directed by Vic Morrow.
I think seven people saw it, and you were launched into a wonderful career. And I put on pointed ears.
I didn't start directing film until I was 38 years old. I'd been around the shooting of the entire I Love You, Alice Bitoklis, which I co-wrote and co-produced with Larry Tucker.
You fellas really become heroes in Hollywood in recent years. You started out writing the Danny Kaye Show.
Middle, before we start out, take one good look and eat your heart out.
And went on to help create the Monkees.
Hey, hey, we're the Monkees, and people say we monkey around.
We wrote that zip, cut, bang, whack. Mm-hmm. We're responsible for ruining everything with the MTV style.
Can I have your name?
And now Alice B. Toklas, which I really enjoyed and is causing a big sensation.
Looks like a nice brownie.
Was really where it's at in terms of people trying to find themselves today.
I think it kind of, you know, for myself, was where I think I was at. I think a lot of middle-class people are looking for something more. They've gotten a message from kids.
Thank Alice B. Toklas.
You're my parents in a Junkies.
Bob and Carol and Ted and
That's
Alice.
That's a good offering to us.
And we wrote Bob and Carol and Ted and Alice. I said, if I don't direct it, I won't sell it. And the rest is history.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
It's a movie about two couples who try to be straight about affairs.
I had an affair when I was in Miami.
About who they've slept with.
Are you in love with her?
No, of course not.
I don't see how I can feel jealous about a purely physical thing you had with some dumb blonde.
Not dumb. She just got her master's at Berkeley.
They get into trouble and complications and funny ones.
Well, what do you feel like doing?
Orgy! Have an orgy!
We took the treatment to National General, it was a new studio, and the guy said, it's too dirty with these couples switching. I said, well, I think I can get Paul Newman and Joanne Woodward. He said, then it wouldn't be dirty.
First we'll have an orgy and then we'll go see Tony Bennett.
But I never really thought about controversial, and I still don't. It wasn't dirty. And the movie's really about love.
Now, do you want to do it just like that with no feeling on my part?
Yeah.
We made the movie, cast Donald Sutherland, Ellen Burstyn.
For me, the most important thing about Paul is that he is a good man.
This is my wife.
I'll get high.
Dad!
That was my child.
My daughter Meg played Donald's daughter. Alex in Wonderland came because Larry and I, who are now, you know, the new kings of Hollywood, headlines in Variety and Reporter.
I saw a preview of your picture, and I think it's fantastic.
We don't know what to do next.
I see Huckleberry Finn as a 17-year-old kid.
We have no movie, we have no idea, we have a deal with Frankovich.
A revolutionary.
We're one-shot wonders.
America is the shore.
Let's make a movie about our problem. And Larry says, but isn't this 8.5?
You're Federico Fellini?
Yes, but I am working now.
I said, so what?
Hooray for Hollywood.
We had to show it to Jim Aubrey. Aubrey says, I like it.
Hooray.
I don't know what to do with it. After the failure of Alex in Wonderland, I had moved to Italy with my wife and kids. I'm writing the story of Harry and Tonto, and I get Josh Greenfeld to start the first draft. We're turned down at every studio. I was very depressed. I sit down, and I start to type a scene with a guy sitting at a cafe in Venice, Italy. Who's saying voiceover in this gorgeous place, as you see, it's great to be in love. Love is wonderful. I'm in love. The problem is, I'm in love with my ex-wife.
Hi.
Hi.
What are you doing home?
My cold got worse, so I took the rest of the day off.
I brought my work home with me.
Hi, Mrs. Brown.
Just get on past the awkward place we're at.
Okay.
There's nothing to it.
It's such an honor to be part of this tribute to Paul Mazursky. He's our Bergman, our Fellini.
This here
song's about Chester.
And he's also one of the funniest human beings I've ever been around.
You've become a very sick man, Stephen.
I know, Kurt.
You really do love her, don't you?
Marcia Mason.
It really was Paul who discovered me. I'm so moved because he's really responsible for my film career.
Neil Simon later saw the movie, and when he saw Marcia Mason, he fell in love with her. Alan Ladd Jr. got a job as an executive at Fox.
I would still be at Fox if I hadn't made your movies.
And he said, I love it, I'd like to do it, mm-hmm. but you've got to do it cheap. Mm-hmm. And you got to get an actor, you know, with a name. So I go and get Art Carney.
Do you remember me?
I had to talk him into it. He didn't want to do it.
I'm 59 years old. How can I play a 75-year-old guy?
I said, well, you have varicose veins, you're deaf, you're bow-legged, your hair is going.
Dumb son of a bitch!
Come on, Art. Nah, I can't do it. I'd never make it.
There you go.
His wife is there with me.
You love me?
I'll tell you something, Harry. I don't always like you, but I do love you.
And the wife says, he's going to do it. I'll get him to do it.
Tyler!
Art Carney for Harry and Tonto. Albert Finney for Murder on the Orient Express. Dustin Hoffman for Lenny. Jack Nicholson for Chinatown. Al Pacino for The Godfather Part II. The winner is Art Carney in...
What other words besides thank you, Paul Mazursky and Josh Greenfeld, for a gem of a script, and particularly from my wife, Barbara, who said two words to me, do it.
You are old.
Oh, this is a long movie. Do I have to stay to the end?
I'm not the only guy who's used his life, but not enough directors use their lives, in my opinion.
Larry, where are you going with all that luggage?
Greenwich Village.
What's in Greenwich Village?
Fame and fortune.
It's very much about me. Story of a Jewish boy who leaves Brownsville and goes to Greenwich Village.
You call this an apartment? I don't call this an apartment.
You call this an apartment? I don't call this an apartment.
The Danny Kaye writers called me, oh, Mr. Greenwich Village is here. He's wearing a beret today.
I think about suicide once or twice a day.
Suicide makes you feel talented.
I don't think that's very funny.
They made fun.
You're crazy!
Little did they know.
I don't want to live!
What can I tell you? People get hurt.
What would happen?
I love you, Sarah.
I know.
I'll always love you.
No, you won't.
And we took the picture to Cannes, and it was a huge hit.
Do you know the punishment for a slave who strikes a Roman citizen?
I know.
Death by torture.
No.
You?
Crucifixion.
Wrong.
They shove a living snake up your ass.
Ah, no, but that's very creative.
All I want to say is that I love you, and I'm very proud of you, and I'm very proud as an American of your work.
I mean, everybody I know is married is either miserable or divorced. I don't want that.
Patty, that's ridiculous. There's a lot of happily married couples.
Name three.
A woman friend of my wife and mine came to us. She was no longer married. She was divorced. She just got a house. And on the deed, they had her name. And next to it, it said an unmarried woman. An unmarried, a new species. So something clicked, and I started writing it.
Tell me.
I would love if somebody else. Seeing another woman for over a year. I don't want to hurt you. I want to hurt Patty.
You tell Patty that you're sorry.
And Jill was fantastic. She was in Gable and Lombard. She was getting hot.
Hello.
Fuck you.
But she wasn't a big star.
I'm sad, I'm lonely, I'm depressed. What do you want me to say?
I gave her the part, and the studio went with it.
Stop the cab! Stop it!
Sorry, I didn't...
Get out, you son of a bitch!
Laddie's a great guy. He's got guts.
Come in.
I just want to see how it feels to make love to someone that I'm not in love with.
It still surprises me how many women, they come up to me endlessly, you don't know what this movie means to me. That's my story. How did you know that? How did you write that? I don't know.
We're tired of being prisoners!
Tough shit.
Because Paul gave me my first job ever.
Ooh, wah, ooh, wah.
I said I want you guys to sing together. I put songs into the movie. The way Shakespeare would have.
Why do birds sing so gay? Lovers await the break of day. Why do they fall in love?
It's a guy who's having a nervous breakdown, basically. Mm-hmm. And what the play was about to me.
That's a good question.
You shut up!
It's about forgiveness.
And this goddamn vase bores me, you understand?
Go ahead, break it.
No matter what happens.
If you touch my daughter, I'll kill you.
Can you learn to forgive?
Why does the rain fall from up above? Why do fools fall in love?
Oh, that was fun to make.
You also worked with Robin Williams?
He had done The World According to Garp.
Right.
He was very good in that. He did Moscow and the Hudson. I think he was very good.
Moscow, we don't need Russia.
Robin learned Russian fluently enough to play the first 20 minutes of the movie in Russian.
I defect.
Hey, what's up? I had a defector with between Estee Lauder and Pierre Cardin.
Are you the one defecting?
Yes.
We don't like that kind of thing here at Bloomingdale.
I know, ma'am.
My only thing with Robin was contain him a little bit, which I...
Okay, mister.
I think I achieved it.
One order McFries, two chocolate McShakes. Come back, McSoon.
He's brilliant.
Maria Cheetah, I said, okay, I want you to take a bath with him. Okay, I take a bath with him.
What is date of Declaration of Independence?
Whew!
July 4, 1776.
Robert couldn't get out of the tub.
Paris door.
It's kind of a secret paradise.
My country so lovely.
Is it safe to eat lettuce here?
Assassin!
South American town. He's met the dictator, and he looks just like him.
People of Baridor, I love you.
And they make him play the dictator.
I got a part for you to play.
Who are your casting agents? The Gestapo?
No.
It was my most expensive picture. And Dreyfus agreed right away to do it.
I'm Bobby De Niro.
Raul Julia.
Play the part or I'll kill you.
Make a very good director.
Sonia Braga I met with, she was really hot.
So?
Her English was not too good, she talked more like the old signing. But she was delightful.
Because I dance good.
Judith Malina was supposed to play Dreyfus's mother, and her agent made a mistake and she didn't show up in Brazil to play the part. So I played the part.
Mama!
Everyone said you had lost weight. I thought you had contracted syphilis. I know you don't like me. Who cares? Your father and I managed to have a child and we hated each other.
You are my mother, and I love you.
Made to love.
I saw a homeless guy pushing a cart with a lot of tin cans and crap and a little dog in the alley where I live in Beverly Hills. And a bulb flashed in my head like in the cartoons. Boodoo saved from drowning.
Hey!
Hey!
Call 911! Call 911! Call 911!
I called 911!
I cast the entire three stars in the Betty Ford Center. I told everybody. I went to see Eisner and I said, here's what we got. We got Richard Dreyfuss.
Cops are gonna come.
Oh, I have no green card.
Got Nick Nolte. I mean, he says, very good, but he's not funny. I said, it doesn't have to be funny. Don't be mad at me, Nick.
You wait till I get my hands on you.
It's gotta be real. Because the actress I have is gonna be funny. Who'd you get? Bette Midler.
Wow!
He jumped up and hit the ceiling.
Wah bam bloom bam blam bam bam to the boot. Oh,
there goes the neighborhood.
And it was a big hit. So now I knew I was invincible. I could do anything, and I gave them Enemies of Love Story. It's a comedy by Isaac Singer. What's it about? I said, it's a guy with three wives.
He has another wife. How do you manage it? Do you rush from one to the other?
I do the best I can.
It's a period piece, Michael. He says, well, can't you update it? Update the Holocaust? Lena Olin. She told me I was the greatest actress director she ever worked for. She said it to the paper in Stockholm, and Bergman was pissed. He was so pissed. My greatest sex scene, as far as I'm concerned, Enemies of Love Story. I want to do it in one take. Cuts make all sex scenes unreal. The minute you cut, it's dissolves and fades, and then I want the real thing. And I'll come in tighter and tighter, one take. 2 weeks before we start. Ron, he's a little nervous. But I know that. I say, yeah, but you don't have to do it. You just kind of rehearse. Lilith's fooling around. She's scratching his bare back, standing up, and Ron's turned with his face. He's facing me in rehearsal, and he goes, she killed him. I'm back to, I'm trying to get another movie made. I have two scripts out. One was written in 1832 that I wrote. So I do a lot of acting.
Nobody fucking move!
Sopranos.
Very bad, boys.
This is a low-level game, guys.
Shut the fuck up!
If you can keep your head while those around you can't, then you are...
Curb.
Drop a ball!
Ah!
You've been looking for 20 minutes. Just drop a ball.
I haven't been looking for 20 minutes.
You can't hold up the whole course like this. It's very inconsiderate.
I'm not inconsiderate. You're inconsiderate.
You're inconsiderate.
No,
you're
inconsiderate.
Are.
You want to do me a favor?
Yeah, yeah.
You
what?
Shove it up your ass.
Fuck you, Norm.
I'm not working my butt off because today I had a facial at 10 o'clock to prepare for this. I hope it looks good. I'd be happy to do it again.
What the world needs now. Love, sweet love, it's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow. There are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to shine. Oh, listen, Lord, if you want to know. That there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, oh, but just for everyone.
Betsy is here, and we've been married 61 years. I knew this was going to happen.